of our five players throw the one of the biggest hook balls on the PBA Tour. They're going to scatter a lot of strikes. It's exciting action on hand. Now let's see how the PBA players are checking out the championship pair. First, there's Oil down 40 feet on the lane. A fairly good shot with a heavy concentration in the center. It's a little dry in the back end. The line the players are playing, all right-handers, are from the center of the lane, swing out very close to the edge of the lane, swing back into the 1-3 pocket. If they can keep it in play, they get a lot of strikes, Chris, and there's a lot of money at stake.
The total here in Las Vegas for the Showboat Invitational, $175,000, 35, 18, 10, 8, and 6,500 for last place finish in this field of five after 56 games. We're getting ready to go. Speaking of coming up, ABC's Wide World of Sports, as we look at Debbie Thomas, great skater, even better now than ever, going against Rosalind Sumners and Denise Bellman of Switzerland. And of course, in the men's competition, three-time defending champion Brian Boitano meeting his old nemesis Brian Osser and a rival Scott Hamilton. That's Figure Skating, World Challenge of Champions, plus the Athlete of the Year presentation.
Chris, in the first match, Chris Warren, the experienced player, has been winning for the last couple of years with the Powerball, going against the only conventional type player we have today, another Texan, Phil Ringener. Ringener will start the match.
All right, Chris Warren, who has four titles, Phil Ringener with one regional title, feels after 13 years he is long overdue, and how true. Looking good this week, finishing fifth. A lot of effort put into that shot, though, but he left the 10-pin.
Well, he's kept the ball in play, and the key on the championship here, we showed you how the oil was placed on the lane down 40 feet, will be the right-hand lane. All the players in practice seem to have a pretty good shot to the left-hand lane, lane 59 here. And if they can hit the right-hand lane, it could be the key to victory. Easy spare for Ringener, good spare shooter across lane.
Phil gets it sticking at the line. He's checking out his slide now. He was 19th last week at the AC Delco, his 11th television appearance. Now for a more experienced and a four-time winner, 16th time on TV, smallest and mightiest, 5'5", 115 pounds, Chris Warren of Dallas. Fans among viewers.
Nobody gets more on the ball for a player of this size as Chris Warren. Five-step delivery, high backswing, cupped wrist. Look at that at the top. The good pivot step, low profile at the line, slides about a foot behind the foul. And look at that good follow through and extension. And that's just all wrist action that makes that ball turn over right to left. He's on target.
He was fifth here last year. The benders here today.
Ooh. You're right, Chris. And if they can keep the ball around the 1-3, the power, the 3-pound, 6-ounce pins, the lightest pins available for bowling are in use today, they can throw some strikes.
With a spare up here is Ringener of Big Spring, Texas. Crossing over and leaving the 5-pin. Young man that started at age 6. His parents owned a bowling establishment. His father still owns it.
Ringener with a lot of experience, a lot of it taught by his father, Chris. Five-step delivery, very conventional style. Has one little problem as he gets to the line. Sometimes he snaps his head up right there. You see it before he releases the ball and he pulls it off his target. But he's a very accurate player and he can get hot.
And his best finish was in a long format championship, the Brunswick Memorial. He was second in 1989. Last year won telecast. He teamed with Steve Hoskins to finish second in Beaumont behind the doubles winners, Del Ballard and Bob Benoit. Del Ballard keeping score today for us.
Phil Ringener, the full grip, barely touches his fingers into the hole, past the first knuckle, spreads that index finger for control, and a good wrist action.
Okay, striking the third for Ringener. And with a double up, here is a man that can increase his lead to 20.
Hmm.
four pin.
Sends it out real wide. He had 21 balls in the gutter this week, and he knows he has to trust it wide to control that big hook. And if he gets it just a little bit farther out, it's in the gutter. Ball drifts a little high. You see the head pin impacting the two pin, the two flying around the four, taking out the seven. Simple spare for Warren. He will lead by 10.
And the one is fourth title in Wichita last year. Bo mentioned 21 gutter balls. Earlier, Chris had this to say, what effect it'll have on match play.
Oh, I'm just being real aggressive anyhow, and that's where my ball's breaking the best and carrying the best from, so that's where I'm going to play, and if I'm fortunate enough to keep it on the lane, it's going to strike, and if it goes in the gutter, well, I got to make a spare.
Good attitude. Chris Warren is in the lead. We're in Las Vegas, celebrating our 30th anniversary year. The Las Vegas Strip looked like this 30 years ago, and then take a look how it looks today.
Ever wonder why your face hurts after you shave? It's simple. When you shave, you lose face, because you strip away the moisture that's there to protect it, and that hurts. But now you can start saving face with new conditioning hydrogel from Allspice. Used every day, it adds moisture and keeps it there to help defend against the assault of shaving, so your face feels and stays that way. So why lose face? Use new conditioning hydrogel and start saving face.
Just flakes, huh? A little old-fashioned, don't you think? It's too simple. I mean, I know you're going for that good old days thing, but all this makes me think of is the Depression. Now, wait a minute. This doesn't taste old-fashioned. It's good. I like this simple. I like it a lot.
Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
Taste them again for the first time.
Here in Las Vegas, the man with whom we've had a long-time friendship, fun guy, he's president and CEO of Showboat Hotel, Casino, and Bowling Center, good athlete himself, loves all sports, Frank Modica. We're glad that he joined us here today.
Phil Ringener up in the fourth frame needs a strike to even the match.
No.
You could hear Ringener say, oh no, on that shot. Pulled the ball left of his target, broke up the 3-10 split, has an easy spare. He'll still trail by 10. See the ball pushing through. The head pin takes out the 6, 9, and 10. 3-pin, no problem.
Okay, Phil Ringener talked about working through some injuries he had suffered right here this week.
Well, Thursday morning I pulled a groin muscle in about the 7th game. And it kind of worried me. I thought I was going to have to withdraw, but it really helped me. It helped me slow down, and I made good shots and helped me keep aggressive.
And this week's bowling tip of the week is on speed control. Watch later on in the telecast. Now, Ringener up, trailing by 10, fifth frame.
And Phil leaves a 10-pin.
Well, we can see so far that neither player has had any trouble hitting the pocket on the left-hand lane. Lane 59, this 106-lane establishment. He leaves a solid 10. Not much you can do about it. Just stay there and keep plucking away. Ball bouncing a little bit as he lets go of it, and you'll see in another player we have on there, Mark Bauer, how far he lost it over the lane later on in the matches.
All right. 268 bowlers starting here in another Showboat Invitational. And in that group, it's took 211 average to make match play. Low gain this week, 92.
Tommy Kress, one of my good friends, he had to be reeling a little bit or a little unlucky.
Tommy makes us all feel a little more human, though.
And Chris Warren gets a real good break that time. You see the ball hanging almost into the channel. It's really the spin on the ball that keeps it from dropping off into the channel. Look at it coming right into your living room, hanging right on the edge. Breaks high, breaks up the 4-10 split. Once again, an easy spare. He needs this to maintain an 11-pin lead through five.
This is an all-Texas first match. Chris Warren of Dallas, Phil Ringener of Big Spring, and though I know two of my Texas native friends, Byron Nelson and Carol Shelby, are eating this one up.
Those men both love their bowling, and you see Chris Warren's mother. She has been to four telecasts. Chris has won two of those tournaments. She'd like to make it 60%, winning his third in her fifth appearance today.
And Mom won't like that, nor does one of her 10 children. Six boys, three sisters.
10 children, none of them like this, including Chris. You're right, Mr. Schenkel. The ball cuts right through the center. He leaves the 3, 4, 6, 7. Needs to get the ball over on the right-hand side and slide that pin over into the 4-pin. It is makeable.
All out try. Chris, that's the way he operates. All out. So now it's a 5-pin lead by Big Springs' Phil Ringener. Or made the comment that it's so tough to win on the tour because there's so many great players, Bo, and you know that. Even though you won 17 titles, the competition is tough. He says making a living now is really extremely important.
As his wife looks on, Jill, 4 months pregnant with their first child, rooting for her husband, and I agree, Chris. There's so many well-trained bowlers through the college ranks who have either been through Olympic training or the intercollegiate training. Makes it very tough out here.
There's a 2-pin, Phil, who last year earned $30,555.
That's a shot he really wanted because he knew how to hit that left-hand lane. He could have opened up a 15-pin lead, lets the ball slide by the head pin. Pretty simple spare.
So he earned $2,000 last week. Will that pay his expenses?
Well, as long as he continues to make $2,000, you're in pretty good shape. I'd say it takes about $1,000 a week, Chris.
Okay, we're in our first game, a very close match. 5 pins separating these Texans. We'll be back with more.
Road travelers, be prepared with this Road Pal 12-volt air compressor from Campbell Hausfeld for only $19.99. This auto start battery charger from Shower is just $29.99. It's a booster and charger all in one. And get battery booster cables from Carroll Cable with heavy-duty angle clamps for only $9.99 at your local True Value, the neighborhood hardware store with national chain store buying power.
You made it through Thanksgiving. You made it through Christmas. You even made it through New Year's Eve. Just when you thought you made it through the holidays, along comes the big game. Make sure you still have some Alka-Seltzer.
If you're looking for a shampoo that's tough on dandruff, nothing works better than this. Head & Shoulders Intensive Treatment, with the most effective medicine you can buy without a prescription. There's no better treatment than Head & Shoulders Intensive Treatment. We dare you to have dandruff.
When they perform, they're all champions. But when they compete, only one can wear the crown. It's the World Challenge of Champions, next on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
It's coverage you won't want to miss. World Challenge of Champions. Having done it last year with Peggy Fleming, I can vouch for it. It's exciting. Such grace, such beauty. Such great music, too. Here's a great bowler, Chris Warren, trailing by 5.
Get off, man.
Didn't listen to him. He begged it, leaving the 2 and the sleeper 8. I think his domber down a little bit. That isn't like him. Probably trying overly hard because his mom, Mary, is here in attendance. Watching her 28-year-old son at 5'5", 115 pounds. Took his mom back to Japan, and he went on to win the Japan Cup as the top seed. Chopping the 2 off the 8. Bo. Okay, Bo.
Chris, the man who will meet the winner of this match, Mark Bauer. Mark, What do you really fear? What is the thing you have to guard against in a one-game match out there?
Well, I'm going to have to try to stay clean. The pair doesn't look too high scoring right now, so hopefully the strikes will come and I can make my spares.
He's got a great strike ball, Chris. If he can make his spares, he'll be very tough in the next match. Back to you.
Bowling is cruel. Trailing by five by chopping the two off the hit, he now trails by 16. He can't recover from the error in bowling, but this is the main way, the only way, as they say, to get started again. Chris Warren getting a strike in the eighth frame as the man that Bo just talked to continues to warm up, and you'll hear the pinfall. Ringener now in the lead, the spare up shooting in the eighth. Leading by 16. And retaliates with a strike of his own.
Ringener looks like he's zeroed in the championship pair, and you'll see the position he takes on the lanes. Ringener playing an ideal down and in shot, filling the frames, where Chris Warren playing the big hook has had a lot of open frames. We'll show you exactly what he's doing compared to Warren. Warren's way over on the left side. Phil Ringener is about in the center. He'll slide about right here. He'll target right around the first arrow, so watch his angle. He'll come through here, come right around the first arrow, not play very much hook into the pocket.
His wish. Jill is happy to his wife in attendance, and that was a big double, though.
Yes, it is, Chris. That's the second time he's had a chance to really put Warren on the ropes. He had a chance in the seventh frame. Here in the ninth, he capitalizes. Now he has him in arrears by 26 pins, as you see Chris Warren on the approach.
Strike up in the eighth. Foundation ninth for Chris Warren. Trailing by 26.
Get up! Get up!
210.
Just sends it too wide. The right-hand lane has always had a tendency to hang. Lane 60 on this championship here. Warren looking down at what kind of adjustment he should make. What he has to do is get the ball over here on the left side of the 3-pin. So slide the 3-pin over into the 10 right here.
And again, Chris Warren all out trying to make the conversion. There he is.
Well, for Mary Warren, it's going to be a fifth place finish today. The best Chris can do is 178. Ringener going at a 208 pace. It looks like it's going to be Ringener against Bowers.
Breaking up the 7-10.
First start of year, 160 on TV.
The lifeboat guy like Del Ballard and many of us. Chris is a muscle car fan. Bo drives him.
Right.
We're going to enter him in the Indy 500.
That's it.
In a year now.
That's for sure. Chris Warren, easy spear, cross lane, 7-pin. Best he can do, 168. Not a good day for Chris, but he said, Chris, earlier that he had to take a chance, play the big hook. And it just didn't work today. Too many open frames and no good breaks.
His career earnings of nearly $400,000. Four victories, four Southwest regional titles as well. Last year, four telecasts, and you'll remember he won the Wichita Open. So at 168.
Needs just one pin to win the match. Fairly simple. Still has the potential. 228 can win it by 60.
A 6-pin on the right lane. Big fella at 193 pounds on that 5'11 frame. 33 years old. In his bowling life, and he'll go against Mike Bauer. ABC Sports presentation, Professional Bowler Tour, will return after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Golf's legends play the Senior Skins Game next Saturday on ABC Sports.
Thanks for joining us. Susan, what's new tonight?
Nothing, honey.
Can't you make up something, darling? Kellogg's Nut and Honey Crunch is new with a deliciously sweet new recipe.
Anything new?
Nut and honey.
Anything changed?
Nut and honey.
Anything different?
Nut and honey.
See you tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
It's a whole new Nut and Honey Crunch, and you'll love the nutty sweet taste.
He just won't open up. Watch this. What's new, Pete?
Nut and honey.
Like a brick wall.
New Kellogg's Nut and Honey Crunch.
ABC Sports and Nutmeg Mills have come together to create ABC Sportswear. ABC Sportswear by Nutmeg. Now for the real sports fan, the best is here.
Sunday. With his football career stopped short, his girl on the run, and no candy at the dentist, Tommy gets hooked on an all-new America's Funniest Home Video Sunday.
You never know what kind of copier dealer you got until you have a problem. But when you call a Minolta dealer...
Hello, Harrisburg Copiers. Bob Lloyd speaking. May I help you?
You'll always have a dealer who makes service and response a number one priority. So if you buy a Minolta copier from us, we'll leave no problem unsolved and no question unanswered.
Hey, which one looks like your beer?
Right here.
That one. This is Budweiser. Here's Coors Extra Gold.
Oh, man, just goes to show you.
58% of Bud drinkers prefer Coors Extra Gold in a taste test.
Think they're right. Looks like a better beer.
And guess what else?
What?
Coors Extra Gold was a two-time winner at the Great American Beer Festival.
I believe that.
Slow brewed for that real beer flavor and color, the way beer was meant to be, which may be why...
Gold beats the Bud.
Coors Extra Gold. If you're missing real taste, beer is back.
Well, I'm gonna go get some of that stuff.
Carl Ravitch has the scores and more on 27 News.
The Pro Bowlers Tour, brought to you by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. By Old Spice Conditioning Hydrogel. It's the simple solution to saving face. And by Kellogg's, proud sponsor of our 1992 U.S. Olympic team.
In our battle of Texans, Phil Ringener and Chris Warren. Ringener... edging Warren, 204-168, more than an edge. Four strikes for Ringener, five for Warren. And now, Mark Bowers of Aberdeen, Maryland, a non-winner, comes in against Ringener. Next Saturday, our bowling excitement continues because we head back to California. The world's top bowlers take aim at the ARC Sacramento Open. It's all next Saturday at a special time, get this, of 2 Eastern, 1 Central, here on ABC's Professional Bowlers Tour. 2 o'clock instead of 3 o'clock Eastern.
A little earlier, Chris, and first time back in Sacramento in 17 years. They're looking forward to it, and we'll have a great field. Now the man that won the first match, they used to call him the Fireball out here on the tour because he threw the ball so hard on his first shot, 21, 22 miles an hour. He's learned to slow it down, control it, finesse the ball in the pocket. And he's trying to win his second consecutive match, first shot.
Come on, baby.
And gets that. 4, 6, 7, 10.
What we have here for Phil Ringener is he has to get the ball basically over in this area and just take a chance in sliding one of the pins over into the 4-7. Very difficult shot. Best to go for just 2.
So Ringener starts after his victory in the first match with an open frame. And he knows what those opens can do because the man he defeated had back-to-back opens in that first match, Chris Warren. Now a good look at the 6-footer, 250-pound Mark Bowers of Aberdeen. Second television appearance ever. His other appearance was in Rochester in 1990 where he finished fourth.
Well, the big guy is really all strikes, and you can see from his profile that he's low... he's cupped underneath the ball, gets a big loft out over the foul line, and when he gets striking, Chris, tons of strike. You see that inside-out release, the big snap, that ball errant to the left side of the head pin, but he has an easy spare.
And missing it.
Unusual, although we have seen that before. Remember Amleto Monticelli,
yes,
in the Firestone Tournament of Champions last year against David Ozio in the championship match? miss the five pin. That is completely unexcusable and so unfeathering to a young player like this. How is he going to recover? Boy, oh boy. Can't ask for an easier spare, and he misses it.
Monticelli, incidentally, finished 26th this week. Tom Baker, 27th. That's the way to come back. Now, Ken Ringener, he had an open frame.
Well, you see Phil Ringener right here, starting in this area, a slide in this area, pretty straight approach.
Coming up high, and Phil's really coming out of the box a little slow here in his second game of the afternoon.
Well, this championship pair, Chris, has historically been one of the toughest pairs. What he has to do is get the ball over by the 3-pin, let the ball deflect into the 10 to convert the 3-10 split. Pretty easy for a top pro.
All right. All right. Wide World follows us as it has for all these years, ABC's 1-2 punch. And today it's the World Challenge of Champions, men and women, three-time defending champ Brian Boitano against Orser and Scott Hamilton, Debbie Thomas and Rosalind Sumners trying to defeat the famous Swiss Miss Denise Bellman. That will be immediately following us, along with the Athlete of the Year presentation. Wide World.
Now.
All right.
Gets the wall shot, a good break, keep it thin, and watch him spin. Now you see how Bowers is playing the championship pair. It's way over here on the left side of the approach. He'll slide at the foul line here. Pretty straight shot. He has to give a lot of room.
Trying to take an 11-pin lead was Mark Bowers of Aberdeen.
Got a great break there, Chris. He had the 2-8-10 standing. The head pin swirled in behind the 2-8, knocked him out, left him the 10-pin spare. But remember, he missed the 5-pin in the opening frame, so this has to look like it's awful small 60 feet away.
All right. Five-year veteran Mark Bowers described earlier how he developed more consistency in recent years.
Well, it seemed like I've learned to play the different conditions a little different and try to stay a little more under control. You know, it's a little different from bowling legs where you just, you know, every ball seems like it just goes right to the pocket because of the lanes. And out here, it's not like that. You need to make a little better shots and stay under control, and I'm trying to learn a little bit every year.
And that's the way to do it, Chris. And I figure there's about 20 pins difference between tour lanes and the PBA.
You remember this tune recorded by Chubby Checkers 30 years ago?
Looking good, get into Bud Light. The clean, fresh taste won't fill you up, never let you down.
You can't pitch it, feel it, know you got it right. Everything else is just a light. Everything else is just a light. Everything else is just a light. Everything else.
Lots of men have heard about minoxidil, and lots of men have heard about Rogaine. But lots of men don't know that only Rogaine has minoxidil, and only your doctor has Rogaine. For more information, call this number now.
If you want to get the complete story about Rogaine with minoxidil, what it does and how it does it, see your doctor or call 1-800-274-8270.
Uptown Information Center.
That's 1-800-274-8270.
Bowling's best are out to make a point that the ARC Sacramento Open begins an hour earlier than usual. Next Saturday on ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour.
All right, we go to the capital city of Sacramento a week from today for the finals of the ARC Sacramento Open. There's a new time, not 3 Eastern, our customary time. It'll be 2 Eastern, 1 Central. Next week's telecast. Phil Ringener now. He has a strike up. big shot. You heard the ohs and ahs from the crowd, leaving the 1-2-4-10. Let's see what he'll do now with this split. There they are. To the left of center. Lots of speed, and that's the way to do it. 1-2 pocket on the left, and Bo, you did that often in your career.
You're right, Chris. I left it a lot of times. I didn't make it quite often. That's the reason I'm down here with Harry Sullins, who's going to be in the semifinal match. Harry, you're a proven winner out there. You get to go against a player who's never been in the winner's circle. Do you feel you have an advantage in that match?
One small advantage is that the experience, sure, I've been there, but it's a one game, anything can happen. And you try to take them one frame at a time, and hopefully my experience will win out, and we'll just have to wait and see.
I think with the experience, Chris, he does have an edge. Back to you.
And Phil Ringener, trailing by 10, putting some pressure on another non-winner, Mark Bowers. Mark finished 56th last week in the AC Delco Classic at Gable House in Torrance. Last year earning $31,478, cashing in 13 of 24 tournaments. So with the 310, Mark Bowers in our second match. If you just joined us, the first was won by Phil Ringener over Chris Warren, 204 to 168.
Chris, and the scoring is low, and as you see, Bowers cutting right through the middle, leaves the 310. He's quickly up on the approach. He's going to cross lane. He's a tough shot, but he makes it.
Beautiful. Mark is from Aberdeen. Aberdeen, Maryland, midway between Wilmington, Delaware, and Baltimore.
The championship pair, 59 and 60, for the last 2 years, been the lowest scoring championship pair on our 16-week tour. The player is barely averaging 200. Now, we'll see what Bowers is doing on the championship pair. He's standing here, going to slide in this area, try to start between the first and second arrows. A lot of loft. Chris, we've been sitting side by side, going on 18 years. That Never. Is the wildest shot I have ever seen. I've seen some in the channel, but that's the wildest.
Astray. Oh, my goodness.
He barely catches the four pin going away. He leaves the 1-2-3-5-10. What do you do?
Throw it hard as you can possibly throw it and holler whatever. Six pin lead now by Ringener.
Here's how he converted it. We don't have this in our Betamaxes of how to make spares and overhead shots. We never thought it'd be left, but Mark is taking us on an adventure. Now, Phil Ringener has to be buoyed by the wildness of Bowers. He can extend his lead to 14 with a strike and a six.
And he does.
When lanes are tough, we know they're tough. The players knew they were tough going in. The first match was tough. When you do that, you need a more of a ball under control. Of the four, five players in the championship round, only Ringener is what we call a down and in player, keeping the ball in play. If he gets nice and relaxed and really gets zeroed on this pair, he can be very tough just filling the frames. Right now, he can extend to a 24-pin lead, seventh frame.
Come on!
Harry Sullins is in the wings along with Bob Vespi, standing in the way of the winner of this match. Philip Ringener in the lead by 24. We'll be back.
To Speed Stick. It's what more men reach for. To prepare, to prevent, to protect. Speed Stick, 110% protection.
No better way to face the day.
Speed Stick. Speedstick, 110% protection.
When they perform, they're all champions. But when they compete, only one can wear the crown. It's the World Challenge of Champions, next on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Past president of the PBA, Johnny Petraglia, one of the three Triple Crown winners. And he's going to go home for a bit and come back and bowl the last 12 on the winter tour.
Mark Bowers completely lost, and the right-hand lane is the key. There's a little hang spot out there. If he goes around it, he hangs out there. Look at the no break on the ball. If he goes a little bit straighter towards the pocket, he crosses over to the left. Completely lost, has the washout again, has to drive the head into the 10.
So for Mark, it'll be the wrong kind of experience, but he'll remember it down the way.
Well, he's had one other championship round experience, and that was 2 years ago in the fall tour, and he bowled a 170. So one of the hardest things it is for a young player on the Pro Bowlers Tour is get used to that championship round. I've said it before, you got to be a long-distance runner all week long, and on Saturday you got to be a sprinter, and you better learn how to do them both to be a winner.
And it's here amazing how difficult it is to get in the final five, because, as Bo mentioned earlier, it's a 56-game format. That's grueling.
You're right, Chris. And more than 240 top players. There's a very confident look on Ringener. He's asking for a re-rack on the right-hand. No, there's a pin laying down on the lane, on the left-hand lane. Now, for the people at home, if you ever have deadwood laying on the lane and you touch it with the ball, you get zero for that shot. So, wisely, Mark Bowers is waiting for the pin to be removed. On the Pro Bowlers Tour, you get zero for the whole frame. A little more of a penalty out here.
Okay, what's your tip of the week?
Tip of the week this week, Chris, is on speed control, and has been very, very important today on the championship pair. If a player throws a little too hard, the ball slides by. If he throws it a little too soft, as we saw Bowers do a couple of frames earlier, it hooks too much. As you see the human element come into bowling, no more pin boys back there, but it was necessary to remove that pin. Now, an easy spare, eighth frame.
Okay. Bo will be giving you the top 24 finishers a little later on. I can give you some beyond that. Del Ballard and Billy Young tied for 33rd. Ron Williams, 36th. Tom Kreitz, 37th. Pete McCordick, 45th. Bob Benoit, the bridegroom, 48th. Mark Roth, 50th. So with a three-bagger, Bill was trying to make it four in a row.
Historically, the player in the last few years who's ever been able to go straight down the boards, not hook the ball very much, has been the winner on this championship pair. I remember Amleto Monacelli struggling through 2 years ago, and then throwing a straight ball the last game and winning the championship. Ringener's doing the right thing.
David Ozio, the defending champion here, finished 10th. Another Texan from Vidor, Texas. Phil is from Big Spring. No S.
In the offseason, Philip, who was a former high school baseball player, coaches little league teams. Says he enjoys it, and he's got a new baby on the way in another 5 months. So it behooves him to win a tournament and get things going.
Beautiful. And there's Jill. Young lady we've known for a long time. And watching with all of us today, Bobby Dinkins, staff of the PBA. And his boss, Kevin Shippey. Johnny Campos is our tournament director. He's down there seated along with Frank Esposito, who, along with me, shares the luxury of having been with this series 30 years, going in 31.
Mark Bowers, as he comes up in the 10th frame, can shoot a 189 if he strikes three times.
3-6-10.
No good. That's a shutout. Automatic winner for Phil Ringener in the second match, as he's never been headed today. Chris Warren with a 160 game. If Mark Bowers bowls a spare here in the 10th, he'll be in the 160s. Who can give a little competition to Ringener? Will it be the three-time champion, Harry Sullins, in the next match?
So know it's going to be a Ringener, an opportunity to go into his third match. The tip of the week with Nelson Burton Jr., how the ball speed can affect your accuracy and scores.
In the sport of bowling, it's absolutely mandatory that you have consistent ball speed combined with precision accuracy. On today's bowling tip, we're going to show you how this combination makes for success. On this first shot, I've rolled the ball about the seventh board, as you can see, 17 miles an hour. But the ball drifts left of the head pin, too much hook. On the second shot, once again, the ball's on the seventh board, but I've thrown it 21 miles an hour. I throw it right through the break, it misses the head pin to the right. And finally, the ideal ball speed is about 18 miles an hour. I'm on the seventh board, but now the ball takes the proper break into the 1-3 pocket, ending up with a strike. So when you're working on your game, whether it's in league play or just practice, be conscious of your ball speed and you'll be a much better player.
Proper maintenance with AC Delco parts can significantly reduce premature wrinkles. AC Delco, it's like buying time.
Champions. ABC Sports presents an all-new home video, Bowling the Perfect Game. Available only by calling 1-800-4-ABC-VCR. Classic moments in bowling history can be yours for the incredible price of $14.98 plus $3 shipping.
Philip Ringener now has won two matches. In the first, against Chris Warren, 204 to 168 with four strikes. Then he came back against Mark Bauer, five strikes, 206 total to Mark Bauer's 157. So, those other than Warren, Bauer's a non-winner, as Philip is. But now, Harry Sullins, the legend, as they call him, out of the Detroit area. We're at the Showboat Casino Hotel and Bowling Center. And there's where the action is in the games of chance.
I remember coming here, Chris, when there was just two crap tables and four blackjack tables. Very interesting. As you see, the next two stops, the first time in 17 years, we're going back to Sacramento, California, Chris.
And we have to remind everyone, a new starting time for Josh next week, 2 o'clock Eastern instead of our normal starting time of 3. 2 Eastern. So February 1st, back to Grand Prairie, Texas, to the Forum, Quaker State Open, Grand Prairie, $170,000 event.
Very large field here, Chris, at the Showboat, 267 players instead of 160. Very low average, 197. Top 24, 211. Some of the other finishers. Lawrence had a 300 game this week. Goble, seventh place. Marilyn McCord, excellent weeks, $4,000 and $3,500. The defending champion, Ozio, 10th. Mark Thayer, off to a good start this year. The Bowler of the Year, former Bowler of the Year, Voss, Rick Steelsmith, steady as usual. Walter Ray Williams Jr., an early leader here. Our AC Delco leader last week finished second, Wayne Webb. Thomas and Tilton, two good checks right there. Don Moser had some good runs. Ron Palumbi, former U.S. Open champion. George Branham III, one of my favorite guys. McGurr, 21st place. Thompson, steady as usual. Bob Hanley, hooking Bob, 23rd, and rounding out the top 24. Adam Colton, $1,550, a nice trophy, and we're into the semifinal, Chris.
So what's your schedule for next week?
For Bo Burton next week, Chris, I'm going to bowl my first PBA tournament.
No.
in almost 3 years, going to Sacramento Bowl in the ARC Open. A little nervous about it, but we'll see what happens. I'm bowling at a 145 Pro-Am next week, and we'll get it going.
Del Ballard, a competitor, is trembling over there with the fact you're coming back.
Oh, yeah, I can bet on that.
No.
All right, Philip Ringener with a split now here on his very first shot.
Stroke the shot.
Here's how Philip Ringener has to make this. Get the ball over next to the three pin, let the ball deflect into the 10. Same type of shot, overhead, let the ball bounce right into the 10. Philip Ringener has made it once today, needs to make it in the first frame.
And again, begins a game with an open frame.
Well, Chris, right near the end of that last match with a seemingly insurmountable lead, Ringener started experimenting on the championship here in the 9th and 10th frames when he had the match won, and he has slowed down a little bit too much on 59 and is still struggling on 60. So Harry Sullins has a pretty good chance against him. Sullins, a real power player with 3 PBA titles.
The Iron Man. Wide hit, ball not coming up into the pocket, leaving the 2, 4, and 10.
The man with a solid, solid four-step delivery, Harry Sullins. Cocks that ball in the backswing, the big hook, bends the elbow, good pivot step, and good follow-through. Really a good shot, but the ball does not finish at the last 10 feet of the lane.
Nicely done. 3 titles. His 12th time on national television. He led here after the 5th round. Last week, finished 43rd, the AC Delco. Last year, Bo earned $91,000.
Steady Harry. He just keeps getting better and better. Very likable guy, very confident guy, and he's a real worker out here on the tour.
Product of the junior leagues.
And of the bowling leagues in Detroit. In fact, he got his start on the tour by fellow teammates encouraging him to come out and try the tour. He had some early success, but he was kind of erratic. Now he's established himself, more experience. He's very consistent. As Phil Ringener tries to figure out the right-hand lane, he started with an open.
Crossing over.
All the players are lost on this championship here, and I have bowled on it a few times. I had the good fortune of winning this tournament once, and what they must do is play the outside line and swing it on 59. Then stay outside with a lot of speed and throw almost a perfectly straight ball on the right-hand lane 60. Now, in the left-hand lane, he has to just swing it out and keep doing what he's doing. When he comes up on the right-hand lane, we'll show you what he has to do on lane 60.
Talking to it with that strike, now trails only one. Philip Ringener, Big Spring, Texas. As Harry Sullen wastes no time getting up, drying off the ball. What's his reaction? Now his opponent to go up again by 11 with a strike.
Harry Sullins with the dropped ring finger grip. The big cup needs to crank it up. Chris, he's looking at the line. There's not much he can do. Now, I say he's got a lot of experience, but a lot of these power players don't know how to straighten the ball out, and it's just going to be potluck on this lane. They must throw the ball straight down the outside, take all the hook out of the ball. A player like Mike Durbin, former champion, a Billy Hardwick, a Gary Dickinson would slaughter this championship pair, but they're not here today, so these players must make the adjustment.
1-3-6-9. No. Harry Sullins, known as the Iron Man, has competed in every tournament the past 5 years. He explains his motivation.
Well, Bo, I look at it as a job. I'm bowling, trying to earn a living, and if I'm not bowling, I can't earn a living. The money's great. Sometimes you don't earn it. Sometimes you do. Secondly, I like to bowl the invitational tournaments, you know, the Japan Cup, the Reno Invitational. If I don't bowl, you can't earn points to get those. And third, you know, the travel around the country, it's nice. During the winter, you know, you get to miss some of the bad weather, and you get some good weather, and you meet a lot of people, and that's part of the sport of bowling, and that's the part that...
And Harry can rebound from an open frame, as he just did. Still trailing by 13, but we're early into our third match, the semifinal here in Las Vegas. We'll be back.
They ate the same lunch, got the same heartburn, but his antacid is very different. His Tums has calcium. Most antacids don't. Regular Rolaids uses an aluminum salt. This uses aluminum and magnesium. So does this. Of all these, only Tums helps wipe out heartburn and gives you calcium you need every day.
Something my body needs anyway. I like that.
Calcium-rich Tums. That's the one you want.
Biggest names head to the Big Island of Hawaii for the big one, the Senior Skins Game, beginning next Saturday on ABC Sports.
Skin Game. Speaking of head-to-head competition, we've got it right here, as we have had for 30 seasons on the Professional Bowlers Tour. Philip Ringener, Big Spring, Texas, has won two matches, now going against Harry Sullins in the semifinal to earn the right to meet Bob Vespi in the finals. Leading by 13 with a double up. He wanted to get them all, but he's left the 1,
boy, this
2,
lane
4.
Has got my problems.
He is mic'd. As Bo's been pointing out, this right lane, the pair is very difficult, but the right lane in particular. Careless, hurried it. Hurried it, Bo.
It's bad when you don't know how to shoot a spin.
Okay. You're right, Chris, and all the players struggling. Bob Vespi, our tournament leader, do you have any particular game plan, especially for the right-hand lane as our tournament leader?
Yes, it seems to be that the right-hand lane is being the dominating factor here. I threw my 4 practice shots before this match, and I had a pretty good shot, but I'm going to try something different right before I bowl my match, and let's see. I hope I make the right moves and have some good luck.
What are you going to try different?
I'm going to try to get a little bit more direct on the right lane. It seems like the more you go away from the pocket, the more bad breaks you're getting.
He's got the right ticket, Chris. We'll see what happens in the championship match.
Okay, Philip Ringener with the miss, with the error. Came trailed by 2. Came back, though, with the strike. He's still disgusted with himself and the right lane. Now it's Harry Sullins of Detroit.
Looks like Harry's moving deeper inside, more towards the center. Let's see what kind of success he has.
Wide World of Sports follows us, and it's featuring great ladies and men's figure skaters in the World Challenge of Champions. Men, Brian Boitano, Brian Orser, Scott Hamilton. The ladies, Debbie Thomas, Rosalind Sumners, and Denise Bellman of Switzerland. We'll also learn who will be Wide World's Athlete of the Year.
Key shot for Harry Sullins. He leads by 12. He can hit this lane. He needs to keep his pocket on this lane and open up a big lead. Now for Philip Ringener, Chris, we'll show you what he needs to do to really hit this championship pair. As you see Phil Ringener on the left-hand, Sullins on the left-hand lane, the big hook. No doubt about that strike. Now Ringener needs to get the ball right in here and throw it almost perfectly straight into the 1-3 pocket. If he swings it wide, he's going to hit light. If he moves to the center of the lane, it'll drift. Now throw it
Come
hard
on.
Right there. He's got it now, Chris. Now he has to execute. He can get right back in the match. That was a big double. This is the first match where I think both players kind of know what they want to do. I still say slide advantage Ringener. He trails by 12. If he can strike here, he'll cut it down to just 2 pins, and he's got the right shot.
Ringener with, without a doubt, the strongest voice in the lanes that we've heard in a long time.
Mm.
Well, they've seen the ball go so many different directions as he takes one of his two re-racks allowed in each match on the left-hand lane that when they see it heading towards the pocket, they root for it. Now, key shot, seventh frame, trails by 12, can cut the lead to 2.
Sliding by, and again, yeah, 1-2
through that terrible. Up at the line. All kinds of stuff.
Needs to get the ball left of the head pin, drive the head pin into the 10 to convert the 1-2-4-10. Ball right in this area, send the head pin into the 10. That's the way you convert it. He needs this to stay close in the match.
And it's another open frame for Philip Ringener in the semi-final match. We're at the Showboat Invitational. 33rd time the pros have come here.
Fortunately, my heart attack wasn't the end of the world. It was kind of a beginning. To help prevent a second attack, my doctor prescribed exercise, eating right, and therapy bear of enteric aspirin. Enteric means it's safety-coated to help protect your stomach, because it doesn't dissolve in your stomach. I asked my doctor if this regimen with therapy bear enteric would really make a difference down the road. That's why I'm doing it myself, he said.
Therapy bear enteric aspirin. Take it from your doctor.
We're not doing anything. Where's the surprise?
What? Do they whistle or turn purple or something?
These are just flakes. Mmm. Now that's a surprise. They don't have to do anything. They just taste good. Simplicity. It's very tricky. I like that. What are you going to call them?
Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
Kellogg's Corn Flakes? Isn't that name taken?
Taste them again for the first time.
Bowling's best are out to make a point that the ARC Sacramento Open begins an hour earlier than usual. Next Saturday on ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour.
Two key executives here at the Showboat Resort, Casino, Hotel, and Center. G. Clifford Taylor, Executive Vice President, and Jack Cook, who's the manager here of the Bowling Center. Extremely professional in what they do.
Harry Sullins, seventh frame, 28-pin lead, can make it a runaway if he can strike here. Sorry. This match is not over, Chris. Nobody can figure out the right-hand lane except Ringener, and then he makes that horrible shot in the seventh frame on the left. I don't know if this is fun to watch or not, but he's looking up at the count to make sure he gets a good count. He needs to get the ball first place to the right of the three-pin. Drive the three into the 4-7. Not impossible, but pretty difficult. Changes balls to a ball that'll hook less, hopefully to control it. Gives up the count, and there's one thing that would come to my mind as you see a player like Harry Sullins who'll switch balls, use that straighter spare ball for his strikes on the right-hand lane, and the ball that hooks on the left-hand lane, I think he could skin the cat.
Well, in football, when things aren't going too well, you can punt. Unfortunately, in bowling here, you can't punt.
Punt or timeout, that's for sure. These guys need a timeout, but the match is still on. Sullins leads by 8 pins, 8th frame. Ringener now studying the scoreboard as he's back in the match while sitting on the bench.
Meanwhile, Bob Vespi, non-winner from Plantation, Florida, just waiting. Now that he's rubbing his hands to meet the winner of this match and get on that championship pair and see how he can do today.
Boy, if you knew your opponent was going to bowl a 150 or 160 before you ever started, you just shot against a blind score, I'm sure you would take a little different angle of attack, and these players have to look at it that way. Just keep those frames clean. Now, Ringener, 8th frame.
Come on.
He should talk to the ball more often. Next Saturday, ABC Sports presents 4 of the biggest names in golf, teeing off in one of the sport's most entertaining events. Jack Nicklaus, Arnold Palmer, Lee Trevino, and Chichi Rodriguez vie for big money in every hole of the Seniors Skins Game. Coverage begins next Saturday, 3:30, 2:30 Central, right here on ABC, and it'll follow our ARC Sacramento Open.
For Ringener, the biggest shot. He can win the tournament because he's got the right shot. If he can defeat Sullins, this is a key one.
What a break!
Defeating Chris Warren, 204 to 168, then Mark Bowers, 206 to 157.
not an artistic strike, but it really got the job done in the key ninth frame. He now takes the lead. He gives it the left turn signal. Something good has just happened for Phil Ringener. Now, can Sullins strike in the ninth? This is his key shot. I think the man that wins this match has a great chance of going on to winning the tournament. Let's see.
Harry Sullins, after graduating from high school and on to major in bowling lanes management at Vincennes University. And in the industry, Bo, you've been involved with, he's done just about every position that you could have.
You're right, Chris. He was on the Vincennes bowling team, got his experience to come on the tour. He also was a lane maintenance man, a lane checker for the American Bowling Congress. Now it comes down to crunch time. Sullins leads by eight. He can shut out Ringener with two more strikes. He's up on his best lane.
I hit.
Boy, oh boy, he sent a great shot out there in the ninth frame, sent it wide, got it back on his tough lane. Now he eased up in the tenth on the left-hand lane. The match is wide open for anybody to win. Ringener knows. He wants to take a peek. What's happening out there? What did he leave? Now, Harry Sullins is asking for a ruling. It comes this, very simply this. The three pin, that's the leading pin. This pin right here is leading the three pin. He says that the machine set the pin off. Now, this pin here should be right on spot. See a spot like this? The pin should be right on center spot. He says the machine came down and moved this pin over. Now, watch. The man will move it back on spot. If it's more than a quarter of an inch off center or the machine moves it when he picks it up, a player has the right to ask to be reset. Now, this is a key shot. Remember, this is the 10th frame. He needs to make this to maintain the lead.
Is that depth perception or not?
Ooh. Chris, you alluded to his being in every phase of the bowling business as an American Bowling Congress lane inspector. He knows that those pins have to be, and he knows his rules. So now he's put himself in a position to win. He leads by five pins. Best he can do is 193.
Harry Sullins.
Ringener, the frame of reckoning. This could be the shot that wins the tournament. Even though it's the semi-final game, he needs a strike and a good count to win this match and go on to the finals. If he doesn't strike here, he finishes third. Should have gone with his natural instincts there, Chris. Just throw it as hard as he could. We call him Fireball. He needed his natural shot on that. He threw it wild, and it's going to be Harry Sullins and Bob Vespi in the final.
ABC Sports presentation of the Professional Bowlers Tour will return after this message and a word from our ABC.
Organized with the accessible 16-gallon storage container by Tucker. Get a few, they're just $10 each. Then double your closet space with the Closet Made Organizer. It extends from 5 to 8 feet and it's just $36.95. And tough work calls for True Value suede leather work gloves, just $2.77 a pair at your local True Value, the neighborhood hardware store with national chain store buying power.
Alka-Seltzer Plus goes to the Arctic Circle, where the toughest colds live.
Alka-Seltzer Plus takes care of the aches, the runny nose.
Alka-Seltzer Plus has done exactly what I've needed it to do.
It does the job.
Alka-Seltzer Plus, tough medicine for tough winter colds.
If you're looking for a shampoo that's tough on dandruff, nothing works better than this. Head & Shoulders Intensive Treatment, with the most effective medicine you can buy without a prescription. There's no better treatment than Head & Shoulders Intensive Treatment. We dare you to have dandruff.
I know you want me.
My son's job is to keep alive a family tradition.
Let go of me.
Susan Day, Bed of Lies, Monday.
Guys, it doesn't get any better than this.
Walt Smith was wrong. Because when Muskrat Mike discovered gold, it got somewhat better. And when the Swedish bikini team came downstream, it got a little better. And when reinforcements of Old Milwaukee arrived, it most certainly got better. Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee Light. It just doesn't get any better than this.
A perfect game starts with the perfect equipment, and Bowler Supply is right up your alley. Personalized fitting and custom drilling to improve your game. Check out the colorful selection of bags, shoes, and apparel. With the pool player, rack them up on a new billiard table. Choose from in-stock tables or have one custom crafted to complement your decor. We stock accessories, too. For all your billiard needs and the largest inventory of bowling supplies in Central PA, visit Bowler Supply, 401 Carlisle Avenue, York.
MASH, tonight at 11:30 here on 27 WHDN.
From our ABC studios in New York, here's Frank Gifford.
We'll be returning to today's final match in a moment. But coming up next on ABC's Wide World of Sports, professional figure skating's World Challenge of Champions, featuring former world and Olympic gold medalists in both the men's and the ladies' competition. So today we'll present our Athlete of the Year award this year to two exceptional people. From track and field, Carl Lewis, and from gymnastics, Kim Zemeskal. And speaking of outstanding performances, American skier A.J. Kitt finished second in today's World Cup downhill in Kitzbühel, Austria. It was the best American finish in that event since Buddy Werner won in 1959. We'll have the complete story of that race on Wide World of Sports on February the 1st. But right now, let's return to Chris Schenkel in Las Vegas. Chris?
Okay, Frank, thank you. Phil Ringener defeating Chris Warren in the first match, 204 to 168, then came back to get another victory, this time over Mark Bowers, 206 to 157. Then from Detroit came Harry Sullins in a very close match till the very end. He defeated Ringener 193 to 170. So the final match here in the Showboat Invitational now is set up with three-time winner Sullins, non-winner Bob Vespi, who is anxious
Chris,
to win.
Chris, two big hook ball players. They both, obviously, Sullins struggled. All the opponents have only averaged 165 today, so any good game will win the match, and it's going to be pretty interesting.
Yesterday afternoon, it was most interesting to see the Benoit boys take brides here in Las Vegas. And throughout the year, many of our professional bowlers have gotten lucky and married lovely ladies. Here's what we mean.
I do and I will. Those are the two big ones. I do and I will.
And I won't anymore.
Do you have the ring?
Got it.
Okay.
When we're walking down the aisle, the pants are going to come off. So we're really going to have some fun. But this book. Down? Who's going to help me with the tie? I got no shot with a tie here. Yeah. Come here with me. I'll think. I'm ready.
In the last several months, a number of professional bowlers have taken time out to tie the knot. Some weddings took place in the home. Others in traditional church. One even occurred on a luxurious yacht. So let's toast Randy and Becky. Pete and Kim. And John and Leslie. And along, of course, with the rest of our newlyweds. We at ABC Sports wish them all the best of health and happiness in the future. We're in Las Vegas. Happiness to them all. And it'll be a happy winter here. And it'll be a hard-earned victory because after 56 games, we had five finalists. Now we're down to only two. Winning the semifinal match, 204 to 193 to 170. Sullins. Now the score was his match play. Match against Bob Vespi, whom we get a look at now. Nice young man, 5'11", 170, 23 years old, did not bowl in the AC Delco Classic, Bo.
Well, this is really his first experience as a full-time National Tour member, and very confident. He charged last night. Let's see if he can do
in the one game match for all the money.
Come on!
From Plantation, Florida, which is just west of Fort Lauderdale.
Bob Vespi, look at that cupped wrist. His thumb's only halfway in the ball. He brings it to the top of the swing. Then he bends that elbow to even get farther underneath it, just like palming a bowling ball, Chris. Then he sends it real wide, very confidently. Look at this grip. Fingers all the way in, thumb just barely in, cupped all the way back in his wrist. Remember Jimmy Keith, the first real power player that did that? Well, this fellow's got it under control. Another Florida player.
Oh, yeah, baby. Yes, baby.
He is wearing a wireless microphone.
He bowled Harry Sullins in the 56th and final game and defeated him last night for the tournament lead. And he was very vocal about it, and it looked like it kind of intimidated Sullins. Let's see what happens here in the early going. A very confident Bob Vespi out with two strikes.
And this day, even, and the strike here on the right lane. All right, there's the answer. Harry Sullins, Bob Vespi.
See how Harry Sullins is playing the championship pair, very much like Bob Vespi. They're going to stand way to the left side of the approach. They'll be sliding on the left side. You think they're making a 10-pin. Then starting it out in this area, approach here, ball speed here, out to the very edge, letting it snap back. A great strike ball, but when you miss, look out. Both players perfect through two.
I hit. In disgust, Harry Sullins walks away, having left to 3-6-8-10.
About the toughest spare that the pros can shoot. They hate to shoot this spare because you can chop the 3-9 off the 6-10. You got to send it wide to the right-hand channel. Here's how you should make it. Get the ball out wide, let it break through the 3-6, carry out the 9 and 10 pins. Let's see what Sullins does right here in the third.
L channel.
Well, when you're throwing that big a hook, Chris, if you give it enough room to convert the spare, it's got to go in the channel. If he doesn't give it that much room, it's going to hook by the head pin. Believe it or not, Vespi did that exact same thing in the second frame of the 56th and final game last night and has recovered with a bunch of strikes. But that's inexcusable. You've got to change your shot a little bit. He has opened the door for this young man. Third frame.
And lead by 32.
Come on, baby!
This time, baby's a problem.
You betcha. 2-8-10.
Oh, my goodness. What do you do here?
Well, you just got to shoot at the 2-8 right here, Chris, and just hope something that bounces out into the 10. Get the pin count. Remember, on the double, Sullins missed them all and has only got 48 in the third. If he can get two of them, he'll still have a nice lead, less than a half a mark.
All right. So now two open frames, one by each. Bob Vespi shared with us his path to the PBA Tour.
Well, I started in junior leagues. It was AJBC then, now it's YABA. I bowled a couple of years there. And then I joined the ABC men's leagues. And last year I joined the PBA and bowled all year in the regionals. And I had quite a bit of success and I attained a sponsor. And I'm gonna go out this year and hopefully I win
baby.
A day and I'll move this around myself for you.
Okay. After the open, Bob Vespi with a booming strike. A baby, he calls it. All right, we'll be back after this.
When you're looking good, you want Bud Light. The clean, fresh taste that won't fill you up. And never let you down.
You can't get it, you can feel it. You know you got it right. Everything else is just the same. Keep your own life. Everything else is just the same. You got it down. Everything else is just the same.
Did I get that right?
That was perfect.
Back in five, Stephanie.
When you're trying to eat right, days like this are a disaster.
This is.
Stephanie Powers talks about Kellogg's Nutri-Grain.
The only time I really control what I eat is at breakfast, and the whole grain in Kellogg's Nutri-Grain gives me a natural start.
No sugar added, no preservatives, nothing fake.
No matter what I eat later, at breakfast I call the shot.
Naturally good. Nutri-Grain. The natural place to start.
Back again, running behind our allotted time schedule of 90 minutes while we were away, Harry Sullins doubled, making this match a beaut. Now Bob Vespi, looking for that double.
Trouble.
Which rhymes with double, and not so...
Bowers. Well, we've seen one wild shot by Mark Bowers in the earlier match, and once again, the big hook ball gets away from Bob Vespi, yet he only trails by 5 pins if he can make this spare.
Bob Vespi was second in the National Resident Pro Championship in Corpus Christi last year, earning $29,000, looking for his first win, though, and look at that score sheet.
Boy, you got a great break there, Chris. Now let's see how Vespi's playing line. He throws a tremendous hook. He's way over here. He's going to slide here. He's going to get the ball in this area. Watch this line.
Oh! Come on, Bob.
More big trouble. What a big player, crank player, has to do like that is send the ball right out to the channel every time. Take your chances. Chris Warren had the right idea. Vespi has to get the ball over here, slide the 4 into the 10, a very difficult shot, and he can't make it with the big hook ball. He's got to throw it hard and straight. I don't know what that was. Where was he aiming?
I don't know.
That's a practice shot for a strike ball on the right lane. Wow, this match is out of control. Harry Sullins has to say, my goodness, if I can't take advantage of this, I'll never win a fourth title.
With a double up. There he is.
Leads by 19, can make it 29. Golden opportunity, 6 frame.
And he left the 310. Man who last year was third in the Brunswick Memorial, fifth at the AC Delco, third at the flagship City Open.
Well, the losers in these matches, we've seen the 310 converted a couple of times and missed a couple of times today. Get the ball over by the 3-pin, let the ball bounce into the 10. We've seen this shot. The losers have averaged 165. That may be enough to win this game if it continues to go like this.
Beautifully done. The winner of this game will receive $35,000, the runner-up $18,000.
2 years ago, for our 8 games on the championship player, the players averaged 195. Last year, 205, combination obviously 200 for the past 16 games on the championship pair, but you add in this week's average, which is the losing score around 165, is going to drop below 200. Very demanding.
Seventh frame, Harry Sullins leading by 17, spare working. An 8.
Well, good hit. Cuts right through the heart. Doesn't get the break. Harry Sullins, who is taking quite a bit of time, and really it's, as you see, his record kind of justified. He has to figure out what he wants to do. He has only 25 seconds with which to get the shot away. He's been using about 20, but right now he has the lead by 16.
Oh, here's a chance for us to send our very, very best wishes for a speedy recovery to our touring professional scorekeeper buddy, Butch Soper, remaining in the Los Angeles hospital recuperating from surgery.
All his pals out on the tour wish him well.
Mm-hmm.
Vespi not liking this. Once again, the 2-8-10. They see how Vespi cocks everything in the bowling ball. Gets his hand. Now that's just torn up. 56 games, 7 straight days.
Wow.
All that power. But many players have that problem. Remember the great Mark Roth was like that. That's the penalty you pay for cranking it up.
2-8-10. Bob stopped talking to the ball.
Set a short of board, was up the lane.
He's just all over the lane. He's a big strike player, Chris, and unfortunately it's a little bit like the John Daly's of the golf tour. If the big driver isn't working or he starts knocking it out of bounds, there's nowhere to go. He knows no other way except Mindy, his wife, is looking on. Bob still has a chance. He can bowl 196, but he needs to get some strikes.
Bob's mother, Linda, is here as well as we look at his wife, Mindy, leaving a 5-pin on the left lane.
Bob, from the southern region, there's seven regionals in the regions in the PBA, and the southern region has about 30 tournaments a year. That's where he got his experience, and they try to duplicate the PBA lane maintenance program, which is more demanding lane condition than you have on a league type condition, but Bob's struggling here today.
Finished third in the voting for the PBA Rookie of the Year honors, won by Ricky Ward, who was on our telecast last week. And now it's Harry Sullins, 34-year-old, putting his experience on the line now, hoping for that fourth victory. He has a spare up, leading by 29, 8 spring. Three, six, eight, nine, again.
Well, Chris, that's the third frame he had on the left-hand lane. Remember what he did last time. He threw the ball on channel and missed all of them. Let's see how he attacks it. He should pick up his blue ball and throw it straight at the 3-6. He's up on the approach. Here's how to do it. Cut the hook down, let the ball impact the 3-6 and take out the 9. Let's see what happens to Sullins. Just barely hanging on. Sullins going at a 191 pace, has a what I would normally say a commanding 25 pin lead, but who knows today? He might throw it in the gutter, he might get 6 pins, anything can happen.
Never seen so many bowlers' heads shake in disbelief. Philip Ringener is right behind us. He's still shaking his head, wondering.
Well, somebody's got to win. That's the attitude you have to have out here. Somebody's going to win $35,000 a day. You just got to grit your teeth, toughen up, throw your Sunday ball the last two frames.
Six ten.
Well, the short game comes in play for the power players. Obviously, they use their power over 6 long days of qualifying, 1 day of practice in Pro-Am to get to this position. But now they have to cut it back, make those spares, and kind of be protective. Sullins, with this spare, would be going at a 189 pace, would maintain a 23-pin lead with just 2 frames left. If you're Bob Vespi, you've never been in championship round competition before, you're leading a tournament, you can get exempt from the Rabbit Squad in the Firestone Tournament of Champions, but you need strikes. What do? You throw it harder, put all the power you can get on it, and if it goes in the gutter, just tough luck. That's what he did, and he didn't quite get the break, but it's not over yet. Marks are no guarantee. Let's give Vespi a spare right here in the ninth. That would put him at a potential 175. That would force Sullins to get at least a decent count in the 10th frame, so it's still anybody's match.
He just joined us. Philip Ringener won the first over Chris Warren, 204 to 168. And then against Mark Bauer, 206 to 157. Sullins came in the semifinal and defeated Ringener, 193 to 170. And there is Sullins. Tournament leader has been this man, Bob Vespi.
What a shame and somewhat demoralizing. And I'm sure he's taping the show. Harry Sullins knows he's a winner now, sitting on the bench. But he can learn from this, Bob Vespi. He's a good young talent. There's the experienced player. He won today, and rightly so. But he can learn by this experience, watch the tape later on, and figure out what he did wrong and change it next time. A disappointing game for Bob Vespi, but a lot of good players had disappointing games today.
That's right. He'll be a winner down the way, I'm sure. We hope so, because he's a likable young man from Plantation, Florida. From Detroit, Harry Sullins. Let's go back to New York and Frank Gifford.
Thank you, Chris. And coming up next on ABC's Wide World of Sports, professional figure skating's World Challenge of Champions, featuring former world and Olympic gold medalists. And we'll present our Athlete of the Year award this year to 2 exceptional people, from track and field, Carl Lewis, and from gymnastics, Kim Zemesko. We'll return to Chris Schenkel right after this.
No better way to face the day.
When the sun comes up, then I'm feeling fine. 'Cause the AM surely is my favorite time.
The morning belongs to Speed Stick. It's what more men reach for, to prepare, to prevent, to protect. Speed Stick, 110% protection.
Speed
Speedstick, 110% protection.
Bud Bowl 4 is right around the corner, and if you have a ticket, you can win $1 million cash.
I get movie tickets, I get concert tickets, I get a speeding ticket. Well, I get a Bud Bowl ticket.
You'll find your ticket where you buy Budweiser, Bud Light, and Bud Dry draft beer.
You're kidding.
I'm not kidding. What are you waiting for?
I'm going.
Pick up your ticket at a participating store, and you just might be a winner. Bud Bowl 4, this time it's for $1 million.
To get rid of her gray, my wife can spend 40 minutes. But I discovered this 5-minute hair coloring.
The revolutionary discovery called Just for Men from the leader in men's hair coloring. Simply apply Just for Men and in 5 minutes shampoo out.
Gray is blended away. The look of my natural color is back in 5 minutes.
That was me.
And it won't fade or wash out.
My hair takes forever, but you look great in just 5 minutes.
The look of your natural color in just 5 minutes with Just for Men.
Here at the Magnificent Showboat, Harry Sullins, 175, Vespi, 150, 35, 18, 10, 8, and 6,500. G. Clifford Taylor, Executive Vice President, presenting the trophy. Jack Cook, Manager of the Bowling Center, with a check of $35,000. We'll be back next week at a different time, 2 Eastern, 1 Central. For Bo Burton, I'm Chris Schenkel. Goodbye.
Field, 4 left-handers in 5 through 2nd place. But our tournament leader is the man to beat. He's the only righty to survive the 42 games. He's in the announce booth with me now, Robert Lawrence. Robert, what gave you the edge to stay right up there at the top when all the lefties were pushing you all week?
Well, there's a lot of good left-handed scratch bowlers back in Texas, and I bowled a lot of scratch tournaments against them, and it prepared me mentally to not feel at a disadvantage when they've got a good shot.
Well, that's a great attitude. Now, the scores have been fantastic this week. And 242 average for all of you five players. Predict a final score for me.
258-239.
Who's going to win?
Me.
Robert Lawrence. All right. Very confident. Now, the PBA has set up a very easy lane pattern, I feel, this week on synthetic lanes. Here's the way the PBA has set them up. I call it a Christmas tree pattern. There's light oil outside, a concentration in the center, and then light oil on the left side. Now, here's the angle the players are taking.